Environment officers have issued a stern warning urging people to evacuate Katiko landing site immediately. Spanning across the districts of Mitiana, Mubende, Kassanda and Gomba, Lake Wamala has become a water menace for its surrounding communities. Ignoring the concrete pillars set up by fisheries and environment officers as boundaries, many continue to occupy these areas and even construct structures. Unfortunately, the rainy season has persisted, causing water levels on the lake to rise dramatically, leading to widespread flooding. The landing sites have now vanished beneath the water's surface, leaving people desperately searching for means of escape.
This is the situation at Katiko landing site on Lake Wamala. The water levels are rising again, which has forced all the people living around this area to vacate their homes. A number of people are now stranded with nowhere to live. Like you have seen, all the boats are packed and all houses have been flooded by water. Currently, there is no business going on right here. The situation here is almost the same like it is at the all other landing sites on Lake Wamala.
At Katiko landing site, we witness concrete pillars swallowed by the rising water while houses remain submerged. Countless merchandise and property have been lost, leaving only a handful of fishermen persevering in their trade. Godfrey Winda, Secretary for Publicity at Katiko, has resided in this area for 3 decades. Winda explains that the stranded residents had migrated from distant places to engage in income-generating activities, now left with no means to return. Other landing sites like Rubaja in Manyi sub-county, Mtiana districts, have also been cut off by the floods, severing access roads to the lake. Islanders find themselves trapped, unable to traverse the treacherous waters. Local leaders, deeply concerned for the communities, have appealed to the Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, to intervene and support those affected. Yasin Mbira, the District Environment and Natural Resources Officer, sees a silver lining amidst the chaos. He believes that the floods, though devastating, will compel people to vacate the lake. Bira explains that there are repeated efforts to sensitize and warn the public, backed by relevant authorities, have been futile as encroachment on the lake continued unchecked. It further reveals that the floods are aggravated by the increasing number of people seeking land around the lake as the water from Mtiana Municipality and other trading centers eventually flows to Lake Wamala.
Have population pressure along Lake Wamala. So because of that struggle, the scramble for land, even if you sensitize these people, they continue encroaching on the buffer zone because they even have limited alternative sources of income. Most of the population depend on land for survival, farming, and even fishing. So unless we provide alternative income-generating activity to these people.
The district has undertaken restoration projects, including the tree planting along the lake shores and installation of pillars to demarcate boundaries. I'm Loka Jiri, reporting for the news.